Hi everyone. So today we are going to find out some of the array. So we want to create a program in JavaScript which will find out some of the array. So in JavaScript we can have array like this. So this is the JavaScript array and we want to find out some of this array. So how we can find out? Like we can have a variable like s. So initially we can have s as 0. So we will traverse through the array with I index and we will go to each element and we will add each element within s. So like first we will start with our first index which is number 1. So we will come here and we will add into s. So it will become 1. So again we will go to second number and we will add here, so it will become 3. Now we will go to next index and it will become 6. Again we will go to next index, so now we will add 4 with 6, so it will become 10. Now we will add 5, so then it will become 15. So like this we can traverse whole array and we can add numbers. So we will write a function to find out some of the array. So we write function with function keyword then name of the function. So we can have name as sum and we have to provide a parameter which will accept argument as a array. So array, and like for find out sum of a function we have to call this function also like sum, and we have to provide argument. So argument will be array only 1 2 3 4 5. So any number we can provide any number of elements in the array. So we have a variable called s and initially it will be 0. So we will traverse through the whole array and we will try to add all elements with s. So we have we will use for loop and we will use I index for traversing through the array. And so only we traverse from first index to last index. So last index will be array length minus 1. So like this we will traverse, and at each number while traversing at each we will add each number with s. So we'll add all elements with s. So here we are adding all the elements in s. So now after completing the for loop we will have sum of the all elements in array with s variable. So we can print this variable also with console.log. We print any variable or strings on the screen. So we will print x. So now we will run this program, see output 15, it is printing 15. So what is happening here? So at line number 11 we are calling some function and we are passing argument as a array. So 1 2 3 4 5 it is array and we are passing arguments. So now because we are calling this function, so we will go to line number 3. So your function is defined with function keyword and sum as a function name. So this is a array is a parameter and we are capturing this argument in this array argument in this array parameter. We have s variable, initially it will be 0, then we are applying a for loop to traversing from each element of this given array, And while traversing each element, we are adding each element in S. And after this, we are after completing the for loop, we will have a sum of all the elements in the array in S variable. And line number 8, we are printing S variable. Okay. So like instead of printing line number 8, we can return some of the array also. So how we can improve this program? And so now we will try to return this value. So how we can return anything from a function? So we have to use return keyword, and we will return this sum of the array. And while right now, what will happen at line number 11, whenever we call this function, it will go to line number 3 and it will process with the function body, and at line number 8 it will return 15. So here, whenever function will come again at line number 11 after processing this function, so it will have 15 value. So we have to capture this 15 value in some other variable. So we have to use another variable, like we can use var. So with var keyword, we depend a variable in JavaScript. So we can have return val as a variable name. So return val will have 15. So we can print return val here. Now we will run this program and see, it is printing 15. So what we are doing here, we are calling at line number 11, we are calling this function. So and we are passing this array as argument, and in the function we are traversing through the whole array, and we are returning some of the whole elements, and we are capturing this sum in the return value variable. At line number 12, we are printing this return value. Okay. And so how we can make this program much better? Like there is no need to define another variable return val. At the end, we are printing this return value. So we can directly use console.log there itself, and we'll call this function from the console.log only. So how we can use, like console.log, and we will call this function from console.log only, and here we will call this function. So now we will run this program and we will see the output. So it is printing 15 here.